We want to see a green light.
Hi, John here. Bit of an update on our Tesla supercharging problem. If you're not familiar with that, just backtrack a bit. I've done a video up here which details all about it, so you can have a read of that, or watch of that even. Well, you can read it, I guess, because there's subtitles. But anyway, and there was a comment on there from Andy, which was a great one, and he said, have you tried a public charging CCS connection to see whether that works? And I thought, you know, I haven't. All I've done is the type 2 connection, which you can do at home, and that works fine. So we've just dropped out to Peterborough Services, where they've got the Ionity chargers, the DC fast chargers there, and we've just connected those up to try and see whether it would charge. Connects up okay, went through all the payment option, and no, nothing, nada. It wouldn't charge, it gave a fault. Which sort of points towards the fact that it is something to do with the CCS connection, or the two pins of the CCS connection at the bottom of the charge port. So yeah, it's booked in for Monday. We're with Tesla service in Milton Keynes. I've got a loaner. I'm not sure what the loaner is, so we'll find out what that is on Monday. So you'll join me next on Monday at Milton Keynes, and I'll give you an update then. Morning. I've just arrived at the Tesla service centre in Milton Keynes. Just parked up and just going to drop this car off. There's some kind of key boxy scenario here. Contactless exchange, and pick up my loaner car. Okay, so that was easy. So we're looking for a black Model S registration. That Model S, not around there. Must be over here somewhere. Over there. Model S. So I've just had a confirmation on the text message from Tesla that the Model 3 is ready for collection. They've sorted out the problem with it. Apparently, two things really. One, they did a software update, and there's a couple of people said that when they've had exactly the same problem, we've been unable to supercharge, that the ranger or service centre sent a software update, forced one, to the car. And I've just had an update confirmation come through for 2020.36.11, and that's installed on the car, so they've done that. And they also noticed that the front louvers at the front of the car don't open, and they should open when the car supercharges, which means that if they don't open, it can overheat. So that may certainly have been the problem. Anyway, they've fixed that and the car's ready for collection. So I can take this loaner back and go and collect our car. So that's what I'm going to do. So that's the swap over done. I've given back the loaner, the 75D Model S, which was good fun. And now back in my own car. And it's funny, isn't it, how you always prefer your own car, whatever that car is. It's all familiar and comfortable. It's all been fixed apparently, so I'm going to go and test it. Okay, you have to guess where we are from the photo. So I've come to Milton Keynes to see if the supercharger works. So fingers crossed, we are good to go. So let's go and have a look, shall we? So let's just turn you around. It's difficult to see. Flip that. Charge ports open. Get out the car. Yay! So we want to see green light. And you'll now see we are supercharging. So, great news, fixed. All good in the hood, as they say. Any comments, any questions, drop them down below and I will respond. All right, normal stuff, like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. Thanks very much. Take care. Bye.